internet, and today we're going to do another book opinion. This time, Mary Janes Davis, Swimming Without a Net. This book is the second in a series. However, preface, I did not read the first book because it was like this big. It was an adult book, and I was like, I know I can read you without ever reading the first one and still understand what's going on. And guess what? I did. Overall, this book was pretty fun. There was nothing really mind-blowing about it. It was simply a good time. This follows a young woman named Fred. She is a marine scientist, and she also happens to be a mermaid. She's half human and half mermaid. She also has this little love triangle going on between another marine scientist and the merman prince, or future king, you know, and there's that sort of thing going on. Mermaids are showing up at her door, and the mermaid people are like, hey Fred, we need you to come to this special meeting for us because we have some important things to talk about and we want you to be there. And so the whole story goes from there. Overall, I found a lot of the humor very funny. I liked how brass Fred could be. Not only is her nickname is Fred, but she is very assertive in her nature, and she just is out there. One thing that I did find really annoying about this book, and what was a pet peeve of mine that I found really bothersome in this particular book, was the fact that Fred freaks out about a few things, right? So it's all reasonable and logical for her to freak out. Like, she is a mermaid and she's always hidden herself from society, and all of a sudden all of these things are coming down and she's really worried about her being found out, but not even her, but all of these mer people that she has just met. And so she's very concerned about it, and she doesn't want something to fall back and be her fault. So her automatic reaction is to freak out and be like, hey guys, why is this person here? What are they doing? You know that this could cause us danger. You know that we could get in trouble for this. You know that this could harm us in the long run. And while at times she goes overboard in that, it's all logical. You can understand why she is freaking out, why she is worrying so much. But each time she does this, everyone just pushes her off as if, oh, that's just Fred, you know, haha. Fred, you just need to calm down and get laid over there. You got two handsome men. What are you doing over here freaking out? You just need to be a little more calm. Little old Fred, why are you so violent? Why are you always freaking out? And it got on my nerves because I'm like, why are you treating her issues, her worries, like they're less than? Like she's just some child throwing a tantrum because they don't have a toy. She has valued concerns. She cares. She doesn't want you getting hurt or in trouble, and you guys are pushing her off as if those are invalid, as if they're nothing. And once again, I understand that Fred herself wasn't like this grand character, wasn't the epitome of justice and innocence, valor or anything, and she had a lot of bad traits, and sometimes she could take those freakouts overboard or have them pretty often. But you knew that each of those came from a logical place. They weren't unfound. They just went on a little too long maybe, but to treat someone's worries as if they are nothing, as if they're simply jokes and this person's freaking out a little too much, I can't handle that. That diminishes them. I have gone through that where people just like write me off and they're like, oh no, your freakouts are nothing. It bothers me to no end. So while this book overall was pretty fun and it was like humorous and there wasn't anything like too complex about it or anything like hard hitting, it was just a good time, I couldn't enjoy it fully for that simple fact. Because I couldn't stand the fact that our main character had legitimate worries about her people and the dangers could fall on them, and everyone brushed her off every time as if she knew nothing and her worries weren't important, and I couldn't handle that. So overall, Swimming Without a Net was pretty decent. I had a good enough time. I liked the humor. I liked Fred's character. I did enjoy the character of some of the others, but I didn't like how they just threw off Fred's problems as if it was just Fred over here freaking out too much, you know, because that's just a little habit Fred has. I did not like that. Perhaps if I had read the first book and been introduced to all of these characters that very first time and seen them that way, I might not have been as bothered and would have seen the humor in what they were doing, but I did not find it humorous. I found it troubling. and it hit a nerve of mine, and I couldn't handle it. So if you've read this book, or if you've read books like this, or you have had issues like this in the past, comment down below. Let me know. What do you think about it? What's your opinion? Subscribe if you like what you're seeing, and ring the little bell to be notified every time I put up a new video. Links are down below, and goodbye, internet.